This is the life story of that great personality in whose memory this monument has been built.
Cherry tree, who should climb but little me? I held the trunk with both my hands and looked abroad on foreign lands. I saw the next door garden lie, adorned with flowers before my eye, and many pleasant places more that I had never seen before. I saw the tempting rivers pass and read the skies with looking glass. The dusty roads go up and down with people traveling into town.
Ma! 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 Ma!
What happened, Bhakti Lata?
See, they are making faces at me.
Why are you teasing your sister? You have become so naughty. Let your father come. I'll tell him.
They always tease me. They always make faces at me.
Don't cry. Oh, Bhakti Lata.
Like an English lady today.
Yes, mother bought it for me today.
Good. You look very nice, but you would look even more beautiful wearing a sari.
Baba, Baba, is this Aka?
Shh, Bhakti Lata, listen very carefully. It's a surprise. We don't want anyone to know. You and I together, we are going to give them a surprise. All right?
Surprise, surprise, Baba. You bought this car?
Baba, look at that!
Yes.
So much fun. Look,
yes.
You're moving so fast.
Yes.
Look at the tall building.
Hey, look at this building.
Don't put your hand out.
The car is so much fun.
Yes.
Gentlemen, the offerings of such a homage as has been arranged this evening to the Acharya Dev is not a sectarian concern, because when we speak of the fundamental principles of Gurudev or Acharya Dev, we speak of something that is of universal application. There does not arise any question of discriminating my Guru from that of yours or anyone else's. There is only one Guru who appears in an infinity of forms to teach you, me, and all others. Ado, ado, ye all, the happy day, blessed than heaven, sweeter than May. When he appeared at Uri, the holy place, my Lord and Master, his divine grace. O my Master, the evangelic angel, give us thy light, light up thy candle. Struggle for existence, a human race, the only hope, his divine grace.
Children, this is Vrindavan, the holiest of all lands. This is the extension of the spiritual sky in the material nature.
But Baba, you told me that this land is made of touchstone, and all the trees are desire trees, and all the cows are surabhis.
Yes.
Baba, Baba, a peacock!
Yes, they are very dear to Krishna. That's why Krishna wears peacock feathers on his head.
Are all these trees here desire trees?
Yes.
Can I ask for anything and these trees will fulfill my desires?
Yes, but ask only for Krishna Bhakti. This is Govardhan Hill. Come, let's offer our obeisances. Tangewala, zara rukiye. Offer obeisances.
They are circumambulating Radha Kund, and we are also circumambulating Radha Kund. But there is a difference.
Srila Prabhupada, what is the difference?
Generally, people worship Krishna because he is the supreme personality of Godhead. But we are the worshippers of Srimati Radharani. We love Krishna because Srimati Radharani loves him. ABHAY ABHAY CHARAN ARVINDA, when did you come?
Just now. And I was told that you are here and I came to see you.
Oh, you must be tired after such a long train journey. Go take a bath, freshen up, and take prasad.
Srila Prabhupada, let me just be with you now. I'm not really so tired.
Well, if you feel that way, then yes, you can be with us. How is your business?
Actually, it's not going so well.
Well, if you do not give your time and attention to it, then how do you expect it to flourish? After all, in this world, everybody is very attached to money. Everyone wants to grab it and hold it. No one wants to part with it. If you want to become a successful businessman, then you have to learn how to snatch it from them.
I'm not very good at that, Srila Prabhupada.
You could have been, if you really loved money. But you opted for loving Krishna. Therefore, you do not have any interest for it. You come in. I want to talk to you. Take care of his sons and give them some prasad.
Yes, Srila Prabhupada.
Thank you. Sit down. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wants to inundate this world with Krishna Bhakti. Once in a day of Brahma, Krishna comes assuming the mood and complexion of Radha Rani to distribute that most precious wealth of the spiritual sky to anyone and everyone in the age of Kali, the age when practically everyone is extremely degraded. He is the supreme personality of Godhead, so he can give it to whoever he likes. He is the supreme controller, therefore he can make the whole world Krishna conscious in no time. But he wants to do it through his devotees, because he wants to give the credit to his devotees. It is through Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's plan started to unfold in the recent past. He wanted me to help him in this mission, but I haven't been able to do very much.
Why, Srila Prabhupada? You achieved so much. It is due to your preaching that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's message has spread all over India. You have established 64 temples throughout this country. Thousands of people have accepted Krishna consciousness due to your tireless preaching.
But that is just an insignificant drop in the ocean. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy is meant to spread all over the world, in every town and village. I am not going to be here for very long. I feel worried about the future of this mission. When I leave, there will be fire in the mud.
Srila Prabhupada, we want you to be with us for many more years. Therefore, please do not speak in this way.
Abhay Charan, none of us came to this world to stay forever. Sooner or later, we all have to go. And I can see that my time on this planet is coming to an end. Therefore, you have to continue this mission.
Srila Prabhupada, tell me what I can do for you, for your mission.
Try to spread Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission all over the world, in every town and village. Do not become allured by name, fame and position, but try to distribute Krishna consciousness simply for the benefit of others. Always remember that the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, has appeared in this age as His holy name. Therefore, completely depend on the holy name and inspire everyone to chant the holy name.
Yes, Srila Prabhupada. Your order is my life and soul.
Write books and distribute them. Books are the most effective way to spread the philosophy. Whenever you get money, print books. Print books.
Recently, Londoners experienced a most unique and exhilarating event at the City Hall in Wembley. Hypnotic regressor Charles Downs invited volunteers from the audience to become the object of his experiment. The case of 16-year-old Lucy McCollins was most astounding.
Close your eyes. Focus on the pendulum. Pay attention to my voice. You are now becoming sleepy. Your eyelids are becoming heavy. You are now in a deep sleep. Lucy, I want you to try to remember your past. I want you to go back to your childhood. Back even beyond your birth. Where are you? What do you see? Tell me, Who are you?
My name is Laura Jones. They want to hurt me. They think I'm a witch.
Condition, Mr. Tulse immediately brought her back to her present identity. It is good that the Western world is beginning to accept the facts about reincarnation.
What does reincarnation actually mean, Abhay Babu?
Reincarnation literally means to return.
The body dies, but the soul comes back.
Abhay Babu, do you believe in ghosts?
Yes, they are real.
I know of a house which is haunted.
Where?
Near Fauzibagh. It's a large, nice house that belonged to an Englishman. But no one wants to live there now because it is haunted.
Oh, actually, I'm looking for a house.
Absolute sentient, thou hast proved. Impersonal calamity, thou hast moved. This gives us a life, anew and fresh. Worship thy feet, your divine grace.
Had you not come who had told the message of Krishna, forceful and bold? That's your right. You have the mace. Save me a fallen, your divine grace. The line of service as drawn by you is pleasing and healthy like morning dew. The oldest of all but a new dress, miracle done. Your divine grace.
Excellent. Excellent. Bhakti Sudhakar, print it in the next issue of The Harmonist. In the future, whenever Abhay Charanaravinda Das writes something, print it in our magazine.
Srila Prabhupada, that will be very nice. As it is always difficult to get good material, and such a qualified person writes regularly. It will be a great boon for us.
Yes. You can write to him and tell him that I want him to regularly contribute to our magazine.
Yes, Srila Prabhupada.
Always try to present Krishna consciousness in the best possible way. Whatever we do must be first class. Our literatures are the vehicles for our philosophy. We have a very important message to convey to this world, and we must make it a point to do it in the best possible way.
Srila Prabhupada, you made all the arrangements for us to do that. Now it is up to us to carry out your instructions.
Yes. The disciple who carries out the orders of his spiritual master with all sincerity achieves spiritual success. Such a devotee fulfills the dream of his spiritual master. Although ABHAY CHARAN came late, he will accomplish a lot.
It would be nice if he becomes the president of our center in Bombay.
No, let him be. Let him carry on as he is. There is no need to drag him into management now. In due course of time, he will do everything. Absolute is sentient, thou hast proved. Impersonal calamity, thou hast moved.
That the house is haunted?
Maybe.
And you want to move in there?
Yes. It's a nice big house. I actually liked it quite a lot.
But what about the ghost?
Ghost? There's no need to worry about the ghost. You see, a ghost cannot do anything to you as long as you're not afraid.
Not afraid? I'm already afraid. I'm not going to that house.
I'm not afraid. I will go with you, Baba. I want to see a ghost. I've never seen a ghost.
Selection is a brave girl. She's not afraid of a ghost.
Why should I be afraid of a ghost? You told me that ghosts are actually afraid of us.
Selection, you talk too much. When grown-ups speak, you must learn to remain quiet. Just go to your room.
You see, a ghost stays in a house that is empty. But when we move in, they move out. After all, they're afraid of human beings.
I told you I'm not going to that house. Just the thought of it frightens me.
Radha, why do you always have to disagree with my plans? Can't you at least have some confidence in me?
You always treat us like this. You never care for us.
Let's do one thing then. You continue to stay here with the children and let me go and stay there. I'm quite confident that very soon the ghost will go out. And then all of you can come there and stay there with me. Who are you? Do you realize that the condition you are in is all due to your sinful activities. You got the human form as a special gift of Mother Nature. But when you started to misuse it by committing sinful activities, that form was taken away from you. There is a way out of this miserable condition. Actually, your sin is that you rejected the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is the root of all sins. Therefore, if you surrender unto Him, all your sinful reactions will be absolved. The best way to surrender unto the Lord is by chanting His holy name. Please chant with me. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Can't you speak?
It doesn't matter. I will chant the holy name and you listen to it carefully with full conviction that this name is non-different from the Lord Himself. With all sincerity, you surrender to His lotus feet and pray to Him to forgive you for all your mistakes.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
I am eternally grateful to you. Please accept my humble obeisances. My body, mind, whatever I have, I am offering to you, Krishna, the son of Nanda Maharaj. The time has come for me to leave this planet. As I have always said, dedicate your lives in serving Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement. A glorious time is coming. Very soon the whole world will become inundated with Krishna Prem. Therefore, take advantage of this opportunity and become involved in that glorious mission. Manage collectively through a governing body. Become truthful to yourself and become united and fearlessly spread the message of Sri Rupa Goswami and Sri Raghunath Das Goswami. Please continue to spread Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy collectively with a spirit of selfless dedication. Can somebody sing a bhajan?
Maharaj, why don't you sing?
Tirupa Manjari Pado Shemor Shampado Tirupa Manjari Pado Shemor Shampado Tirupa Manjari Sri Rupa Manjari Pado Shei Mor Sampado.
Telegram for Mr. Abhay Charan De.
Yes, that's me.
Excellency.
Cecil?
Good morning.
Please be seated, gentlemen. I'm sorry to have called you here at such an early hour. I've received a very important and urgent communique from the Home Office.
I'm always at your service, Your Excellency.
The Germans have joined hands with the Italians. They've invaded France. They are expanding their territories very rapidly. The Home Office has requested that we mobilize all our troops.
How does Your Excellency want the army to give it support?
The Home Office has ordered us to recruit as many Indians as possible to fight against the Germans.
I wonder how the Indian public will react. I can imagine there'll be quite an uproar.
Put a chair and go. Why should we care about the opinion of the Indian public? After all, we are the rulers of this country, are we not? If someone joins our national army, surely we have the right to send him wherever we like, wherever we choose. gentlemen.
Yes, that's true. We're not recruiting them and paying them just to sit around doing nothing.
But what I mean to say is that there's already so much political unrest in the country, and an action like this could agitate them even more. Besides, most Indians are simple farmers or idle philosophers, and raising an army from this lot will be very difficult.
With all due respect, sir, some Indians actually make very fine soldiers, especially the Sikhs and the Gurkhas.
Maybe. But our experience is that even if we give all kinds of facilities, still people don't join the army. Today, I understand that the total number is hardly more than 150,000.
We will force them to join and make it so that they have no choice.
Your Excellency, I would hardly think that this is a good time to make such a move. All over the country, this Mahatma Gandhi is getting tremendous support for the non-violence movement. A move like this could easily disturb the public.
I don't mean to use direct force. Rather, create a situation where they will be compelled to join the army.
How are you planning to do that?
We should burn all crops. We should commission all food stocks for the use of the army and the war effort. When the prices in the marketplace are inflated to such a degree that the ordinary man cannot afford to buy even his staple diet, he will be happy to join our army. Gentlemen, we shall have our army of Indians.
In every quarter of the earth, men long to be delivered from the curse of war and to find in a world which has regained its peace, despite from the harshness and the bitterness of the world they have known till now. But so often they want the kingdom of heaven without its king, the kingdom of God without God, and they cannot have it. Our resolve must back to Godhead. We make plans for the future, for peace amongst the nation and for civil security at home. That is quite right enough, and it would be wrong to neglect it. But all our plans will come to shipwreck on the rock of human selfishness unless we turn to God, back to Godhead. That is the chief need of every nation today. Hello, you are back again.
I read the magazine I took from you yesterday. I was deeply impressed with your analysis of the world's situation.
Thank you very much. I'm happy to hear it. But what are you going to do about it?
I'm not such a believer in God, but I'd like to point that acute selfishness has made man so inconsiderate and cruel.
Man has rejected God, and that's why he became selfish and envious.
Yes, I agree that faith in God makes a man selfless and caring. India is vivid proof of that fact.
I'm impressed that you perceive that.
I'm actually impressed that in India, despite so much starvation, people are not protesting. They sit there without complaint. In my country, there would have been a revolution by now.
When one realizes that God is the supreme controller, he naturally learns to depend on him.
If I hadn't come to India at a time like this, I would not have understood how faith in God makes man so unconcerned about his material condition. This country has opened my eyes in so many ways.
Auntie, give them to me. I'll carry them for you.
That's all right. They're not so heavy. So how was your program?
Oh, it was great. Many people were there. Uncle Abhay gave a very nice lecture and people liked it. One man became very challenging, but Uncle Abhay smashed him. It was great.
Yes, and Govinda led a sweet kirtan at the end and Prayag played the mridanga.
Wonderful.
Where is Sridhar Maharaj?
Maharaj is upstairs. Go, wash your hands and feet. Prashadam is ready.
Yes, Ma, I am very hungry. What about you, Govinda?
Yes.
Maharaj.
Abhay Charanavinda Prabhu, you are back?
Yes. We arrived just now.
One medical student came to see you. He read your Back to Godhead magazine and became interested. I spoke with him. Quite an intelligent boy.
Oh, that's interesting.
It seems you're getting a good response.
Not really. The response is there, but it is very slow. Most of the people have no taste for this kind of reading. What are you writing?
Just some prayers to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Oh, let me see.
Deva Siddha Mukta Yukta Bhakta Vrinda Vanditam Papa Tapa Dapataha Dagdha Dukha Khanditam.
Wow, it's wonderful. What a brilliant prayer.
Deva Siddha Mukta Yukta Bhakta Vrinda Vanditam Papa Tapa Dabadaha Dagdha Dukha Khanditam Krishna Nama Sidhu Dham Dhanya Dana Sagaram Prema Dham Deva Meva Nami Gaura Sundaram Prema Dham Deva Meva Nami Gaura Sundaram Prema Dham Deva Meva Nami Gaura Sundaram Prema Dham Deva Meva Nami Gaura Sundaram.
Abhay Prabhu,
how are you, Maharaj?
I am leaving for Mayapur now with Govinda. What about you? Aren't you leaving the city?
No. I decided not to go anywhere.
No, Abhay Prabhu. You should go. The Japanese are going to bomb the city.
Let them drop the bombs. I'll just take shelter of Krishna. After all, death may come at any moment. But my business is to depend upon Krishna. I will chant the holy name. The holy name will give me all protection. And if I die then, due to chanting of the holy name at the time of death, I'll go back to Godhead. Therefore, either way, I'll receive absolute benefit.
Abhay Prabhu, what you are saying is true. Yes, why should we run for some material shelter when the supreme shelter of Krishna's lotus feet are always there? I'll also stay here with you.
That will be wonderful, Maharaj. Then we can go on the street and have Harinam Sankirtan.
Let us go.
Where are you going, Guru Maharaj?
We are going out to have a Harinam.
Aren't we supposed to go to Navadvip?
I changed my mind. We'll chant the holy name in the streets of Calcutta, no matter what happens.
May I also come?
Yes, sure. They are all running away out of this fear of death.
But when they see us fearlessly chanting the holy name, while the bombs are dropping everywhere, they'll realize that we have conquered death.
Probably at that time they will take us seriously and join Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Sankirtan movement.
Then let's start our mission.
Hari Haraya Nama Krishna Jadavaya Nama
Jadavaya Madhavaya Keshavaya Nama
Hariharaya Nama Krishna Jadavaya Nama Jadavaya Madhavaya Keshavaya Nama Hariharaya Nama Krishna Jadavaya Nama Jadavaya Madhavaya Keshavaya Nama Hariharaya Nama Krishna Jadavaya Nama Jadavaya Madhavaya Keshavaya Nama
Today's news read. More than 10,000 people have died in the riots in Noakhali.
Yes. When the Hindus were leaving East Bengal, the Muslims stopped the train on a bridge. They slaughtered all the passengers and threw their bodies in the river.
Is this the independence we were looking forward to? I have so many relatives, along with four of my brothers and their families in that part of Bengal. But I don't know. I don't know if they are still alive.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Thousands of people are coming to this part of Bengal. Maybe your relatives are also among them.
How tragic. So many years of struggle for independence ending in this. How do you perceive all these things, Abhay Babu?
You see, the real cause of our distress is our forgetfulness of Krishna. Therefore, whichever way we try to solve our problems without surrendering ourselves to Krishna will always lead to misery. Those who struggled so hard to gain freedom thought that freedom from British domination will bring endless peace and unlimited prosperity for this country. They did not have the slightest idea that the citizens of the same motherland will become worst enemies.
But how do you foresee the future of this country, Abhay Babu?
Well, I see deprivation and despair. In order to remain in power, the so-called leaders of this country will cheat the innocent population and sell the country to the enemies for their petty little gain. Those who do not have any loyalty to the country will become the leaders by the strength of the votes of the ignorant mass. Therefore, what else will you be able to expect from them? So, be prepared for the worst. This independence will simply increase sufferings and problems. There won't be any peace and prosperity unless the leaders become God-conscious and teach their followers how to surrender unto him.
But our leader Mahatma Gandhi is God conscious.
He is a very good man, but he is not really God conscious. He displays some spiritual sentiments, but that is not enough. Unless he knows who God is, how can he become God conscious? I had asked for an interview with you, but your busy secretaries never care to reply this. I tell you as a sincere friend that you must immediately retire from active politics if you do not desire to die an inglorious death. Unless you retire from politics and engage yourself 100% in the preaching work of Bhagavad Gita, which is the real function of the Mahatmas, you shall have to meet with an inglorious death. I tell you as a sincere friend that you must immediately retire from active politics if you do not desire an inglorious death.
Abhay Babu, although you're a distributor of medicine, yet most of the time, you speak about God and spiritual topics.
That is the real medicine that I came to distribute.
What do you mean?
My real business in this world is to distribute the medicine for the spiritual disease.
Spiritual disease?
Yes. Normally people are aware of their material disease, the disease of the body and mind. However, their disease is their forgetfulness of Krishna. In order to cure that disease, Krishna himself came and gave the medicine.
You mean Bhagavad Gita?
Yes. I want to make everyone read Bhagavad Gita and understand its teachings.
But Abhay Babu, practically in India, everybody understands the importance of Bhagavad Gita. Even I used to read it every day when I was young.
You may have read. But did you really understand what is the real message of Bhagavad Gita?
To tell you frankly, I did not. I just used to read it as a ritual. But I did not really try to understand the real meaning of it.
That is why we have to teach Bhagavad Gita as it was given by Krishna and as Arjuna understood it. Therefore, I call my translation Bhagavad Gita as it is.
Your translation?
Yes. I have translated Bhagavad Gita into English with my commentary.
It's amazing. It's amazing, Abhay Babu.
Thank you. Thank you very much. If I get a sponsor to print it, then I will distribute them and give lectures on its teachings.
Abhay Babu, I know someone, a very wealthy person, Dr. Alagappa. He's a very big industrialist and also he's a charitable person. He is considered to be the Birla of the South. I can speak to him. Yes.
Thank you very much. It's wonderful.
Okay.
Come, let's get down.
Sir.
Hello. Good morning, Mr. Hello. Alagappa.
Come in and sit down.
Thank you. Mr. Alagappa, Abhay Babu is a real saintly person. Even though apparently he leads the life of a businessman, he is always engaged in spreading the message of the Lord.
Very pleased to meet such a sincere soul.
As I told you before, he has translated the Bhagavad Gita in English and he wants to print it now for the benefit of the people in general. But he has no desire for any personal gain.
How many copies do you want to print?
Well, about 5,000 would be a good start.
You get the manuscript. I will make all the arrangement for printing.
Thank you very much, Mr. Alagappa. This is a very big favor to me. I'll go back to Calcutta straight away and get the manuscript. I'm prepared to drop everything and settle down in Madras until the book is printed. Mr. Alagappa, I do not have the words to thank you. Manuscript of my Bhagavad Gita. It was on my table when I left.
I do not know.
You don't know?
No.
Did anyone come and take anything from the room?
I said I don't know.
Prayag? Prayag?
Yes, Baba? Were you calling me?
Yes. The manuscript of my Bhagavad Gita, it was here on the table when I left. Did you see it?
No, Baba.
What's happening?
Baba. That's a nice temple.
Yes, it is called Bharti Bhavan.
Let's go and have a look. This facility looks perfect for my use.
This temple was built a long time ago as a memorial to the wealthy Vaishnava landowner Radhabhai. But now, it is not in use.
Dr. Mishra, who you have already met, is occupying some of the rooms here. Otherwise, it is deserted.
Where is Dr. Mishra staying?
Over here.
Dr. Mishra! Dr. Mishra, are you in?
What a pleasant surprise.
I did not know that you live here.
Yes, I occupy two rooms here.
It's a beautiful place. It must be very peaceful here.
Yes, that's true. But the facility is sitting idle.
Who do I contact in order to get permission?
Mr. Devashankar Bhayal is the caretaker.
Where does the caretaker stay?
Not too far away from here.
Then let's go and see him.
I think it would be better if you meet Mr. Ram Mitro, because he is one of your admirers and a close friend of Mr. Bhayal.
Mr. Bhayal.
It's nice to see you, Mr. Malik. Please be seated.
Thank you. I have brought Mr. ABHAY CHARAN to meet you.
Yes, Mr. De. Ram Mitraji told me about your desire to start an ashram in Bharti Bhavan.
Yes.
Abhay Babu is a very learned scholar and a great devotee of Sri Krishna. Many respectable people in Jhansi have started to appreciate him for his spiritual wisdom. If he is allowed to set up an ashram, the whole of Jhansi will benefit.
The place is hardly being used at present, and this seems to be a good cause. So Mr. De can use it for his ashram.
Does he have to pay any rent?
No, it will be given to him in charity.
Thank you, Mr. Bhayal. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
In order to systematically propagate Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's message all over the world, we will need an organization. We will call it the League of Devotees, and Bharti Bhavan will be its headquarters. Although we are starting in a small way, but one day it will spread all over the world. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has predicted that, and his words will not go in vain.
Hare Krishna.
Sanjeev, you are here?
Yes, I've come to see Mr. De.
He should be in the temple. Come, I'll take you.
Yes.
Abhay Babu, see, who is here?
Sanjeev, what brings you here? Come, sit down.
I wanted to speak to you.
Yes. Tell me, what can I do for you?
The other day at our house, you mentioned that India would only be recognized as the greatest country in the world when the intelligent class of people start to distribute its spiritual wealth. What are they actually supposed to do in order to achieve that?
Just the fact that you have inquired proves that you are one of those intelligent men. Firstly, the intelligent class of men must learn about the spiritual culture of India and feel proud about it, and then go out and spread it.
And how can one learn this spiritual culture?
You must first find a qualified teacher.
Where can I find such a teacher?
You must search him out.
Will you please teach me?
Yes, I will. And the book that I will prescribe is Srimad Bhagavad Gita.
So, what are you going to do about it?
Do about what?
Sanjeev, haven't you noticed? Ever since he met Mr. Day, he has changed so much.
Changed? He seems all right to me. Perhaps he has become a little more introspective. But that's natural for a boy of his age.
He's talking about dedicating himself to spreading India's culture all over the world.
Really? That's good. That means he wants to become an ambassador.
No, that means he wants to become a sadhu.
Oh, well, that's not very good. Anyway, it's probably just a phase he's going through. You're just getting into unnecessary anxiety.
But he's our only son.
All right, I'll speak to him. Ram Singh, call Sanjeev.
You're always so busy with your work. You never seem to have any time for us.
Do you want me to stay at home 24 hours a day?
Did you call me, Father?
Sit down, son. So, how is everything?
Fine, Baba.
Now, your mother wanted me to speak to you about something. She heard that you want to become a sadhu and spread our religion throughout the world.
Yes, Baba.
Well, that's nice, my son. But you're still young, and you have your whole life ahead of you. Actually, one becomes a sadhu when he's old. One must go through his life first.
But Mr. Day was telling me that while one is young, one should preach the message of the Lord. What can one do when one becomes old?
That's all very well for Mr. Day to say. Why doesn't he make his own sons into sadhus? Why does he have to steal other people's children?
Well, well, calm down, Chitra. After all, I'm sure that Mr. Day is trying to do that also. But that's not what I'm concerned about.
It is the duty of every person born in India to preach its spiritual principles. I think it's the best thing I could do.
Sanjeev, we've sent you to the best school in the country. We've given you everything you've ever needed. And you want to repay us by becoming a beggar?
Look, son, being religious is good. It's very good. But you don't have to take it to the extreme.
But Baba, at a time like this, when we are rapidly losing our spiritual culture, at a time when our leaders are simply obsessed with Western materialism, we need a class of God-conscious people to change the consciousness of the society. Not only here in India, but all over the world.
We have so many swamis doing that in India. Why do you have to do that?
Material progress isn't a bad thing. In the economic and technological fields, India has never prospered so well as it has since 1947. After 700 years of foreign domination, our country can finally stand on its own two feet. Well, Mr. Day is a great man. Nobody can doubt that. But like all philosophers, he's impractical.
Let's see. Time will tell.
Sanjeev! Sanjeev! Women in India have been oppressed. Now that the country has become free, we have to liberate the women from their unfortunate bondage. Otherwise, what is the use of this independence?
I have been told that a woman should be taken care of in her childhood by her parents, in her youth by her husband, and in her old age by her grown-up children. She is never meant to be independent.
That is nonsense. India as a nation is backward because it has not allowed the women to come forward and take the lead. A nation cannot progress unless the women are treated with dignity.
How will they become independent?
First, we have to arrange education for women.
and then employment opportunities and social rights. We'll call our society the Mahila Samiti Sangha.
To set up this establishment, we need a place. Will you provide those facilities in your house?
No, this is not possible. After all, this is not my house. This is governor's residence.
But your other house is lying empty. Can we set up the Mahila Samiti Sangha there?
No. I do not think it will be large enough.
There is a very nice property called Bharati Bhavan. It will be an ideal place for our society. But it is being occupied by one Mr. Day from Calcutta.
Bharati Bhavan? Mr. Day? Namaste, Mr. Bhaiya.
Namaskar.
Any news about the location for our society?
Well, I don't think there will be any problem. He will not be able to raise that kind of money. Most of his followers are young students. And he himself has recently experienced a serious setback in his business.
Oh, really?
Yes. I heard that during his absence, his factory was burgled. So I don't think that he will be able to pay as his own financial position is very bad.
So when can we get it?
As soon as he leaves the premises.
Here is 5,000 rupees check for you. When he moves out, you'll get another 5,000 rupees.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Namaskar.
Namaste.
I'm leaving. But you all are here. Please continue to practice devotion to Lord Krishna and propagate his teachings. You all have been very nice to me and have helped me in so many ways. Therefore, I'm extremely grateful to you all. Malik Babu.
Abhay Babu.
Where is Sanjeev?
He didn't come, Abhay Babu.
To the League of Devotees.
Yay!
All glories to the Sankirtana movement.
Abhay Babu! Abhay Babu! Abhay Babu! Abhay Babu!
What are you doing here?
I want to come with you.
No, not now. When the time is right, Krishna will make all arrangements. The relation that we have developed is spiritual and therefore it is eternal. It is not affected by the time and space of this material world. Always remember Krishna and continue to chant his holy name. Hare Krishna.
Thank you.
I suppose.
How are you?
Baba, you're here and I'm very happy, Baba.
Good boy, come. So, how are you?
Fine, Baba.
And how's school? You doing well?
Yes, Baba.
So you're becoming a good boy, huh?
Yes, Baba.
Prasade Govinde, Namo Brahmane Vaishnave, Swalpa Punya Vatam Rajan, Visvasanava Jayate.
This is not home-cooked food.
No, we just bought it from the restaurant around the corner.
Why?
Mother did not cook today. She's not well.
What? What happened to her? I saw her walking like a normal healthy person.
I don't know.
Oh, Vrindavan. Have you seen my Srimad Bhagavatam? It was here on the table.
No, Baba. I didn't see it.
Very strange. It was on the table this morning.
Oh. Ma was selling newspapers today.
Did you sell old newspapers today?
Yes.
Did you also sell my Srimad Bhagavatam?
I don't know.
It was on my table.
I told you, I don't know.
Why did you have to sell old newspapers today?
To buy tea and other necessities. Anyway, the whole world can see how my husband is taking care of his household.
Radha. Today you have to make a very important decision. You have to decide whether it's tea or me. Very well.
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Abhaya
पर है भव सिंह।